Welcome to my nail polish collection. So this is the storage itself. It's called the Alex from IKEA. Nail polish en masse is quite heavy, all those glass bottles. The Alex is really sturdy and it seems to hold it very well without buckling or anything like that. There's only one problem with the cabinet, which I will show you later on, but I would still recommend it. As you can see, I have quite a few China glaze. I really like the brand. I buy them from eBay. UK eBay has an international sellers section at the bottom of the page whenever you search for anything, and I buy my China glazes from there, from American sellers. They cost about £4.80. That includes shipping to the UK, and that ends up being a really good price. For the same amount of money, I could buy Model Zone or Barry M on the high street in the UK. China Glaze is a much better brand. My nail polish peels off my nails pretty quickly, maybe after a couple of days. But with China Glaze, I can go for 3 days. It stays stuck on my nails for longer. So if you have peeling problems with your nail polish peeling off, you should absolutely try China Glaze. So, at the back, this is the one big problem with this unit. The drawers don't come out quite enough, so there's a lot of lost space at the back. These are my glitters, and you can see how much space is wasted in the back of that drawer. I could get maybe 2 extra rows of polish, but I can't get my hand in to get them. So that's the one bad thing about this unit. So I've just stuffed the back with lightweight things I don't use often. I've got fake nails from eBay, really cheap and essential if you do nail art, because it's really handy to practice things on fake nails. I've got cotton buds, kind of strange shaped ones, the glitter, and these are extremely cheap makeup sponges from the dollar store, the pound shop, depending on where you're from. At the back I have my crackles. These are black and white, so we'll start with Frosty, which is a shimmery white, which is very good for water marbling, great for nail art. I don't wear it on its own, to be honest, but it is very good for those things. I'm not going to show you the swatch of every polish, because quite honestly we'd be here forever. So I'll only show you a swatch if it's particularly nice. This is Recycle. I don't love Recycle because it's a bit too brown for my taste. I prefer greys that are a bit more cold and clear. It's just too grubby. It's like a dirty grey, but I love Concrete Catwalk. It is the perfect dark grey. Next up we've got Jitterbug, which is a really nice shimmery grey, the first China glaze I ever bought. One of my all-time favourites, Some Like It Hot, from the Marilyn Monroe collection. I love the colours. It's a grey full of holographic glitters. Very nice. So to the purples, I have Spontaneous, which is a fantastic purple. It just seems to work for everything. It's not too dark, it's not too light, it's always just right. It's a Goldilocks polish, I guess. Oh, I love this. This is Creative Fantasy, which looks like blue. It's not. This is Violet. It is a beautiful violet color. I used it in the space tutorial, which I will show right here. And you can see the true colour much better there. It takes 3 coats to cover, but I don't care because it's amazing. Here it is in the swatch. You can see it's a jelly because it's see-through. And it's fantastic for jelly sandwiches. I have to talk about Secret Periwinkle because it's an amazing blue polish. As you can see at the top where it's separated, it's got some lilac in it, and that makes it extremely wearable. Most blues are very cold and very difficult to wear. As an example, this is Secret Periwinkle on the left, and this is a Barry M blue on the right, and you can see that Secret Periwinkle has more of a duskiness to it, and it's got some purple in the mix, and it makes it much more flattering. So if you're ever put off from wearing blue because it's cold, try Secret Periwinkle. It's an extremely flattering colour. I wore it here in the Penguin tutorial. It goes with my pale skin. It would work on older people too, so if you're worried about wearing blue, Secret Periwinkle is a fantastic colour and I'd absolutely recommend it. Next up we've got Hanging in the Balance from the... is it? Yes it is. And this is from the Cirque du Soleil collection. It covers brilliantly. It's almost 1 coat and I use it in the hazard tape tutorial. Then we have First Mate. Oh my god, I love this. This is one of my top five ever. I adore First Mate. It always looks like blue. It's a proper navy, but it never looks like black. It always looks blue. And finally, in the blue section, we have What Are You Waiting For, which is a blue with green shimmer going through. You can see this in the China Glaze Cirque du Soleil collection video that I did a while back. This is a disappointment. This is Sea Spray, which I like in theory. I like it in the bottle, but I hate it on my nails. I used it in this video for the flower design, the flower chain, and it looks nice on camera, but when I put it on my own nails, it just looks, it's got a shimmer. Can you see the shimmer? It just looks kind of dead. It's just a really unflattering color on me. For Audrey is a famous color because it's based on Tiffany's blue, named after Audrey Hepburn. But the problem with For Audrey is it has a horrible formula. It peels off my nails incredibly quickly, more quickly than any other polish. And it doesn't self-level very well, it's quite thick. So if you love the color, I would recommend going for OPI's, is it Mermaid's Tears? And I think other brands do dupes as well. So if you like the color, go to Google and type in China Glaze For Audrey dupe and see other brands, because the formula kind of sucks. And I thought it was just me, but then I heard other people say the same thing in blogs, so it's not just me. And then Shower Together. It is a beautiful teal blue, dark, gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous blue. I love it. The final polish in this section is Atlantis, which I like in theory, but I never want to wear it. I think it's so much nicer in a bottle than it is on my nail. It's a jelly formula, that's why I put a little J next to it. And it's just, I don't like the fact the glitter is silver. If the glitter was teal colored and a little more invisible, I'd like it a lot more. I don't know, I'm being awkward. I don't like it that much, I don't know why. I love Starboard, but I don't like it, but I love it. The thing is, I don't like green nail polish. But if you do, Starboard is amazing because it covers very well. It's a two-coater. It's fantastic for water marbling, and it's just such a brilliant green if you like green. Where is it? There we go. It's just a wonderful kind of pea green, khaki green. It's earthy. I prefer the darker green version. So we've got Starboard on the right, and this darker green is called Holiday. From one of the Christmas collections a year or two ago. It's a very, very dark green, and I like this. It's a forest green. The reason I like it is because it looks incredibly chic and fashionable. We have Running in Circles, an amazing green glitter, again from the Cirque du Soleil collection. It takes three coats though. And then Emerald Fitzgerald, which is actually quite blue. It's a bluey green. Don't trust any of the colors you're seeing on camera, because this is greener in real life. It's very nice though, with shimmer running through it. Next up we have the yellows, Lemon Fizz, disappointing. Kalahari Kiss, quite useful color, but I wouldn't want to wear it on its own. What's this? Oh my God. Electric Pineapple, God, I hate this one, it's horrible. And I hate this one too. I bought them both in a set on eBay and I really regretted it. This is Papaya Punch, and I used it in this tutorial and it looked really good. This is the pumpkin tutorial, and people were saying, oh, that orange is great, what is it? But it's awful in real life. And then we have High Hopes, but I love High Hopes because it's an orange. I don't know if I changed the lighting, if you can see that it's orange. But there's just enough red in the mix to make it flattering on my pale skin. Most oranges look horrible on me, but High Hopes looks really nice. It's got a coral tinge, so it's really wearable. It's the only coral orange polish I have that I'm actually happy to wear. Then this is Escaping Reality. This is a very nice pink. It's hot pink with a touch of neon. The problem with it is it takes three coats, and even then I can still see the white of my nail through it. So I think I'll have to apply it over white next time. This is the colour I'm wearing, which is surprising because it looks, my nails look orange, but the polish looks pink, and that's the same in real life as well. It's a neon. It is extremely patchy. It is difficult to apply. It took 3 coats, and I can still see, I don't know if you can see on camera, you can't, but I can still see the white of my nail through, and I've done 3 coats. So this might be relegated to the pedicure section. This is Igniting Love, which is a very nice red from the China Glaze Cirque du Soleil collection because it's a candy red. Then I have just some other reds, Poinsettia, which is just, I think it's a jelly. Is it a jelly? It'll be on my thing if it's a jelly. I have too many reds. I never wear them. I don't know where I got them. Poinsettia too, because jelly, yep, it's a jelly. It's that one, it's a jelly. Right. Which might be useful. Rainbow and iridescence, that's very good for water marbling. Next up, Snow Globe, an iridescent glitter which will go over many colours. Very handy polish to have. This is Fairy Dust. I did show this in my favourite glitters video, but I've fallen out of love with it a little bit because it smells horrible and it dries. Oh my god, it's so slow to dry. And I thought it was just me, but then other people said the same thing. So Fairy Dust is a really good polish. You can see it's not even moving. It's that thick. It's really gelatinous. So I wouldn't buy it again. I love the effect on the nails, but it's got too many application issues. And there are other versions. I recently bought one from Butter London, which is almost exactly the same effect. So I would try a different brand if you want a fine glitter. Then we have Nova, which I've used quite a lot of. Really good for jelly sandwiches. One of the main reasons I bought it was the name, because Nova is a name I use in World of Warcraft, which is stupid, but there you go. The next drawer is Nice Posh Brands and Nice Posh Brands base coats and top coats. Hang on. I used to keep all of my base coats and top coats in with their different brands. So the China Glaze base coats would be with the China Glazers, stuff like that. So I never realised how many I had until I put them all together. And then when I did, I realised I have quite a lot of base coats and top coats. It's this whole entire section. So I'm using them up. Essie Good To Go was always my favourite top coat. Until I bought a new bottle with this silver cap. They used to have white caps on them. It is much thinner. It is leaving little bubbles and bumps on my nails. It isn't giving a glass-like finish, and it isn't drying as quickly as I'd like. And it's peeling off more quickly. So I have completely fallen out of love with Essie Good To Go. Instead, I'm preferring Posh Top Coat. Dries super fast. I use it over these nails. Now, I've had this on for 2 days now. I have a little bit of tip wear. Can you see the tip wear? I don't know if you can. I have some tip wear. A little bit's come off the corner of that nail. There you go. But it's lasted up pretty well, and Posh Top Coat dries very fast. It's just like Sesh Feet, but without the nasty chemicals and without the shrinkage at the tip of the nail. So I'm loving this, but I have bought Sally Hansen Insta Dry. I haven't tried it yet, but I'm going to give that a go. When I finally used up all these top coats, I'm going to buy Ila Masca base coat and top coat because I love the formula of their polishes. So I want to give those a go, but I need to clear some of this first. Tried Oli Bonder, not impressed. Got an awful lot to use up. This is China Glaze's Strong Adhesion base coat, which was my favourite, pretty good. But then I got this. It was in a set from QVC of the OPI Bond Girl collection, and it came with a natural nail base coat, and I'm really liking it. I'm getting the longest wear from any base coat. It's making the polish stick to my nails just a little bit longer. It is really good. It's also the most expensive base coat I have, so that kind of proves a point, maybe. The more you spend, the better results you get, so I'm really loving this. This is my matte top coat by Essie. I had a problem with it, and other people have had the same problem. It developed little white lumps inside pretty quickly, and I thought the whole thing was just going to be thrown away. But then I tried something. I put thinner in and I put a couple of little ball bearings that you get in nail polish. I took them out of a nail polish, cleaned them up and dropped them in here. Put thinner in a bottle and gave it a damn good shake. And it got rid of all the little white lumps. So it worked very, very well. And it's now absolutely fine. So if you ever have that issue with your matte top coat, that's what you can do to fix it. These are the OPIs. I won't show you all of them. I used to kind of colour in the top, but I've stopped doing that now. Parlez-vous OPI from the French collection. Love this polish. Beautiful formula, fantastic consistency. It goes on like a dream, it covers in two coats. It's a smoky, taupey purple. And I absolutely love it. It is fantastic. I've never seen anything else like it, actually, to be honest. This is a good red. This is Ruby for Rudolph. And it's a very sparkly, Christmassy red. You see the sparkle? I've used quite a lot of it. I wear it every year. For some reason, I will only wear sparkly red at Christmas. I don't know why, but there you go. One of my all-time favourites, Baby It's Cold Outside, a charcoal black glitter, a softer way to wear black. Doo, 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 doo. Mm-hmm. So I'm just going through all the rest. This is Ski Teal We Drop, which has separated. A very nice teal. It's darker than it's looking on camera though. It does look like black quite a lot of the time. And then, this is an interesting one. This is Live and Let Die from the James Bond collection, and it looks amazing. See all that gold? Doesn't it look fantastic? Well, when I swatched it, this is what happened. So here it is in the bottle, amazing, and there it is on the nail. I mean, seriously. Where did the shimmer go? It's the same polish, but when I turn it round, there's a load more shimmer underneath. So the shimmer kind of sank to the bottom. There you go. It kind of sank to the bottom. Well, what good is that when it's on your real nails? So it's, I don't understand. It's amazing in the bottle. I think all the shimmer has stuck to the polish in the bottle, to the size of the bottle, so it looks incredible, but when you apply it, you don't get any of that, which is disappointing. Oh dear, this is my private jet. Now my private jet is very disappointing. I loved it, I thought it was really nice. And then I found out that it was supposed to be extremely holographic and amazing, and it isn't. There were two batches. Batch number one was amazing. People who own it adore it. Great holographic sparkle. Batch number two was a dud, and I've got batch number two. And then my one and only Chanel. This is Blue Rebel, a very nice deep blue. This is my kind of color. Can you see this mesh? This is from a great shop in the UK called Lakeland. It is a rubbery, soft, sticky kind of, it's not that sticky, but it's a rubbery soft liner for your drawer. So I can put my polishes in, give it a damn good shake, and they don't move around that much. You can see I've got a red one in here, and you can see I can give it a shake and they don't move. Very important, because otherwise they would scoot all over the drawer, because the drawers are quite shiny. My Orly collection. Halo, which I love. Absolutely love this. I used this in my Chanel tutorial. Sunglasses at Night, which is pretty freaking amazing. My one and only Butter London, this is Frilly Knickers. It's a really nice, delicate glitter. And then my New Bar, now I like New Bar, I think it's an underrated brand. This is White Polka Dot, and I love it because it's delicate and kind of see-through. There aren't enough big bits of glitter, you don't get many on your nail. Then we have one of my all-time favourites, this is Gem by New Bar, which is an amazing holographic nude. Scattered holographic, it's a bit gritty, so you have to put a thick top coat on. And then a green holographic. This is Reclaim. Yep, Reclaim. Under the lamp? See the holographic? So I only have 3 new bars, but I will be getting more because I like them. 2 Sally Hansen's. I don't like Sally Hansen polish. I hate the brushes. They're like shovels. This is a nice pink. It's called Shrimply Divine, and it's a pink that leans to coral. It's the only coral I can really wear, but it still looks like pink half the time. It's just enough pink in it to make it more wearable, so if you have trouble with corals, it's a good one, but it is a bit patchy. My 2 Layla holographics, which I showed in a video recently. But here are the swatches. They look pretty amazing under the light. This is Layla Flashback and Layla Mercury Twilight. Okie dokie, drawer number 3. We have cheap, nice polishes, indie polishes, and my swatches. So all these swatch thingies live here. They're from eBay. They're really, really cheap. It cost me way more to buy the label maker. I had to buy 4 rolls of tape. Ended up costing a fortune for the labels. I kind of wish I'd written them by hand now. But these actual things are very cheap. You go to eBay, type in nail art fan display, and you should find them. Buy the clear ones so you can see how translucent the polishes are. I actually have 5 of them. Because I wanted to swatch my polishes but be able to mix them up and like take one out and put it somewhere else. You can't do that with a nail wheel. And I didn't think there was anything available, but then I saw these. Now I've put my glitters on these ones because then I can take a glitter and then I can take a colour. And I've only got one hand, I don't know how I'm going to do this. And I can take the glitter and put it over the colour and get an idea of what it will look like, which is so handy. Took me 2 months to do them, but I love doing them because they're now all categorized by color, not by brand. So I'm rediscovering polishes I completely forgot I had. I really enjoy doing the swatches. So these are the cheap brands. I have Max Factor, which isn't available in America anymore. Fantasy Fire. No, that's not Fantasy Fire. This is Fantasy Fire, which is amazing duochrome. I love this one, but it's so thin it takes 4 coats, so instead I put it over dark purple and it looks, 1 coat over dark purple looks amazing. I tried doing a bit of bedazzling, yes, then I realized if I had to kind of really twist on the bottle it'd all come off, so that was a silly thing to do. So I have Fantasy Fire, which you can still buy in Boots right now. In a Max Factor stand, I have a backup of Fantasy Fire. And then I have some other Max Factors. I'm appalled by how small they are. There's barely any freaking polish in these things. These are my Barry M's. Now Barry M is fine. It's a fine brand, okay? It's fine. But it is nowhere near as good as China Glaze, and China Glaze costs 80 pence more. Maybe, you know, like $1 more for China Glaze. So if you're in the UK, buy a Barry M because you love the colour, but please try China Glaze because not only is the quality better, but with China Glaze you get 4 mils more, you get 40% more in every bottle than you do with Barry M. I really like this one, it's called Indigo. No, it's not, it's called Cobalt Blue. It's a really nice saturated blue. It covers extremely well. You can probably get away with 1 coat. The yellow is terrible. I mean, it's lovely. I used it in my smiley face tutorial, but as you can see, always over white or 2 coats over China Glaze Lemon Fizz because it takes 4 coats. Oh, it's so thin. These are the foil effect. They're horrible on their own because you can see the brush strokes, but they're good for stamping. So if you need some stamping polishes in the UK, pick them up. The chameleon one is horrible. I shouldn't say that, it was a gift. Croc effect. I can't make it look nice. It just looks awful every time I try it. Colour Clubs. Now this is a good cheap brand. I much prefer, you know, if you don't have a lot of money, Colour Club is brilliant, and I couldn't get it until I went to TK Maxx. Now I think in the States it's called TJ Maxx. It's the same company, but in the UK it's called TK Maxx, and I can buy a whole set, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, plus a terrible top coat for £7. So that's £1 a bottle. So if you live in the UK, I shouldn't be telling you this, it's a secret. If you live in the UK, go to TK Maxx and snap up the colour clubs. Just don't go to the one I go to, and then I'll be fine. Oh, I love shabby drab. It's a cold grey. It's a bluey, lilac-y grey. I absolutely love it. And then this is a holiday collection, and I was super disappointed. And this is a problem with TK Maxx. So guess what? 11 said, oh, that's a great collection. I love the green called Holiday Splendor. It's a jelly. Well, this is the holiday collection from a couple of years ago, and there's no green Holiday Splendor. This is just a green glitter. It's not Holiday Splendor. They had two boxes. They both had this one in, so they've swapped it out for a different green. So annoying, and that's a problem with TK Maxx. You can't guarantee that you're getting all the ones you think you're getting. The rest are the same. Jingle Jangle and Gingerbread, they're the same, but that one is different. And it's the same with this. This is the, like, this spring's Kaleidoscope collection, and it's got the wrong green, because I've looked at photographs and I don't think I've got the same green. But the rest are very nice. I used this one recently in a video. This is Perspective, very fine flaky polish. And then these are just some French manicure colours. I think I've forgotten the Essies. I have. These are my Essies. I only have three. This is Merino Cool, a really nice deep nudie colour. Like, what kind of colour is it? It's like a taupe. It's very nice if you find it hard to wear nude polishes. This is a flattering colour. And I love Shine of the Times, which I showed in a video, which is a flaky polish. Maximilian Strausser, named after a street called Maximilian Strausser in Germany. And it's weird. Everybody in blog says it's lovely, but I found that it didn't level very well at all, and the application was difficult. So I'm really disappointed with that. I need to get more Essies. It's just, there's always something else I want to buy more. I suppose these cheap polishes are really high street, because I bought all of these in shops. I didn't go online, which is rare for me with nail polish. And continued with Accessorize. I didn't really realise they made polish, and then I was in the store and I had to go and look when I saw the stand. This is pretty amazing. It's called, does it have a name? Oh, what's it called? I can't read the writing. hang on. Oh, Butterfly, it's called Butterfly, there we go. And it's white with red and black glitter. It is really nice. I didn't do a swatch video of it because I don't think it's easily available in America, and most of my viewers are American, but it's a really unusual polish. This is two coats. I think you may need three, I think, but it's gorgeous. And then, my favourite of the two, this is called Firefly, and it's a black with gold glitter. This is three coats, so you might want to layer it over black, but it is a gorgeous polish. I think it's showing it better in the bottle than it is on the nail, with all that lovely gold glitter. They cost £4 each, pretty good value, and I like them. Then I have my natural nail polish remover. I'm not keen on this brand. And my Stargazer. Stargazer is a super cheap brand here in the UK. Oop. And ouch. And I like their duochromes, because look at that. Look at that. This is a really cheap polish and it's amazing. I got them on eBay. You can get them in shops. This is number 307. This is number 307 on its own, and it's very see-through. This is three coats, and you can still see through it. So what I did was I layered it. This is over purple, this is over black. One coat, and you can see it performs much better when it's layered. But there's, it's a beautiful, beautiful duochrome. This is number 305. One coat over black, and then three coats on its own. See it there? And here it is in the bottle. Very nice duochrome. Again, looks better in a bottle than it does on the nail. But for cheap duochromes, the Stargazers are really nice. On the back we have my shimmer polishes, which I got to do a swatch video. Where's my favourite? This is my favourite, Jenny. It's really versatile with lots of different colours. I did a swatch video. I'll link that in the description box. I'll be linking a lot of things in the description box. These are my Happy Hands polishes I got for a swatch video as well. I love this remover, but it's too expensive. These are my three latest purchases from Sonatarium. I did a video on these. I bought these myself. This is raspberry sorbet, blueberry yogurt, and samurai princess, which I adore. Finally, my very first ever indie polish was Come Out and Play by Dandy Nails. Dandy Nails has a YouTube channel. She doesn't post on it anymore, but she now makes nail polishes on Etsy. And even though the glitters have sunk to the bottom, you can still get a sense of how lovely this is. Now, I've worn this a few times. Let me find it. I love the matte white glitters. I just think they're gorgeous. But I wore this on my toes a couple of weeks ago, and it is the longest lasting pedicure I've ever had. This was on my toes for 3 weeks, and I actually had to fill in the line where the growth came through, and then I put crackle over the top, and it looked like a brand new manicure, well, pedicure. But I can't believe how long, this stayed stuck to my nails for. Oh, we're almost at the end. This is the meh drawer, I don't know what you want to call it. Got a few brushes in the back. So this is full of kind of crap. I've got a ton of striping tapes from eBay. Palette, the remover pads I use to clean my brushes with and to tidy up my nails when I'm doing a manicure. And the brush that I use for that as well. Some overuse cream, very nice, not greasy. My spectra flare, which is being horribly ignored, which is a holographic pigment. So these are random brands and polishes I don't like. In the right, we have my Franken, Something Sweet by China Glaze, too pale for my skin tone, so I added some red to make it darker. My one and only Ciate, I don't know. It's a cute bottle, but I don't like the brand. I don't like the formula of the polish. I try to lighten it up by putting some cream in. It's kind of all separated. But I just don't like the bottles. They're very cute, but they keep falling over when you're painting your nails. And the brushes aren't great, and I don't like the brand. This is white with a tiny, tiny bit of black added to make... I was trying to make a dupe of My Boyfriend Scales Walls by OPI, which is a white-grey colour. I think I've almost got there. That'll be handy for a video. I don't even know what this started out as, but I was trying to make a nice nude that glimmered with some glitter. So I took this Born Pretty Store Gold and put a ton of it in there with some brown and some cream, and it's just quite nice. I used it for Rudolph's face in my Rudolph video. These are polishes I don't like, which I could use as a base of a Franken polish in the future. Back here I have my Leighton Denny's, and I do not like Leighton Denny nail polish. Don't like it. It chips the first day I paint it. It's okay on my toes, so I'm using it up for pedicures and for nail art. This is a lovely blue. This is called Daylight Robbery, and it's gorgeous. It just chips instantly. I really don't like the formulas. I don't like nails ink. I don't like the handles, they're awkward to hold. I don't like the formula because it seems to go thick after a year. They haven't lasted as well as my OPIs. My OPIs are in really good condition and are about 5 years old. These are the same age and a lot of them have gone a bit funny. There are some nice ones. This is Victoria, a really nice bright red. I've used quite a lot of it. This is St. John's Wood, an amazing purple. It's more purple than it looks on camera. Great for stamping, and it covers in one coat. But on the whole, I don't like nails ink. I think they are horribly overpriced. Honestly, I just think that the Americans make the best nail polish. There isn't a British brand that I really rate at all. This is Edinburgh Gate.
Very nice, exclusive to QVC colour, which I bought on eBay actually. It's a lovely glitter. Don't like nail ink, it doesn't perform well, so that again, that's pedicure territory and nail art stamping territory. This is my China glaze bowl that I use, well, shot glass, that I use for water marbling. I got it in a Christmas gift set a while ago, which contained Cheers to You and Midnight Kiss polishes, and then this shot glass. I've stopped cleaning it because one, obviously life is too short, and two, I quite like the remnants of all my water marbles on there. I think it's kind of cool. And then these are the random brand. My one and only Zoya. This is Zoya Merino, and I got chipping quite quickly when I wore this, so I'm not that impressed. But I know that other people adore Zoya, so that might just be me. An amazing black. Black Cream by Wet n Wild. Covers in one coat. It's incredible. Had to get it on eBay. So now we have my model zone. I've got six altogether. I bought these for a swatch video a while back. I bought them maybe 8 months ago, a year ago, I don't know. And look what happened. The brushes in all of the bottles have warped and kind of melted. Obviously the formula wasn't very good for the bristles. I just think if you're gonna spend £5 on nail polish, don't buy Model Zone. I can't even close it. Right. Don't buy Model Zone. Go online and buy China Glaze or save up and buy Essie for £7. But don't. I'm really regretting the fact I bought these. I only bought them to make the video. Now I'm stuck with them. So I'm trying to use them up. But I now walk past the Model Zone stand in Boots and I don't even bother looking. I'd go for Barry M every day over Model Zone, but I actually don't buy either anymore. Okay, so the final drawer, hallelujah, is the acrylic paint drawer. Most of my acrylic paints I got on eBay, except for the ones with the gold lids. I got these in a little art shop in Corbridge. I love folk art. They are the best acrylic paints that I've ever used. They're a beautiful consistency and they have the non-toxic logo, which is important because you're putting them on your skin. Your nails are part of your skin. Everything you put on your nails sinks in, and you know, it's important to use non-toxic. I really like folk art. Unfortunately, I bought two sets of six deco art from eBay a while ago. They're grainy and watery and I don't like them, but I've got a ton of them, so I'm using them up. One day they'll all be replaced with folk art. This is a really nice folk art one. It's pearlizing medium. And you can see that pearlescent finish. You can add it to any other colour to make it pearlescent, or you can just use it on its own to make little pearly dots. It's very nice. Very nice stuff. And one of the reasons I use acrylic paints is because they are so cheap. These cost less than £2 a bottle. I bought these 3 years ago in Corbridge in the little art shop. This is my black acrylic paint. It's 3 years old. I have used tons of it, but it keeps getting thick, so I keep having to put water in. So it's still almost full because I keep having to water it down. If I was using polish for nail art, I would have gotten through three bottles by now. Instead, this cheap little bottle is still almost full and is just fantastic. Same goes for the white. And of course, the great thing about acrylic paints is the fact that they don't dry so quickly when you're using them. You can put them on your palette. They last a long time before they dry. But also they don't smudge when you put your top coat on, which is super important. Other things in this drawer, cotton wool, lighting, nail wheels, got some confettis in there. And I got some tape for the tape machine. Little pots, which I thought would be really handy, but I never used them. The tape. This is the tape I use when I do tape manicures. And then my natural nail polish remover. Good brand. Takes a while to remove the polish, but it's good. And my nail polish thinner, which is essential. Never, ever, ever thin your nail polish with nail polish remover. Always use nail polish thinner. And then that's it. Thank you for watching. The links to all the videos I've mentioned are in the description box below. I'll see